Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Hart House Theater Musical Theater Slam in partnership with Singular Sensation. My name is Kimia. I am a fourth year here at the University of Toronto, and I'm joined by...
Hi, my name is Anthony. I am a third year student in the Theater and Drama Studies Specialist Program at UTM.
And we are the UFT Spotlight Work Study students. So for those of you who don't know, UFT Spotlight is a student initiative that runs out of Hart House Theater that is designed to enhance the engagement of students from all three campuses in theater activities outside of the classroom. We organize and run a workshop series, the annual playwriting competition, professional consultee and mentorship opportunities, as well as supporting all of the programming that's being produced behind Hart House Theater. So the Hart House Theater Musical Theater Slam in partnership with Singular Sensation is a new initiative designed to engage emerging musical theater performers and UFT students in this virtual showcase. And this slam is a fun performance opportunity for singers, dancers, and theater artists of all experience levels to increase the accessibility and inclusivity of the musical theater community and provide students and emerging artists with a chance to share their passion for performance while competing for fun awards and prizes. So Hart House Theater has a very long history of supporting the UFT theater community and emerging artists. And this partnership with Singular Sensation has allowed us to provide virtual performance opportunities and educational placements for the University of Toronto students. Before we get started today, we would like to give a land acknowledgement. We wish to acknowledge this land on which the University of Toronto and Hart House Theater operates. For thousands of years, it has been the traditional land of the Huron-Wendat, the Seneca, and the Mississaugas of the Credit. Today, this meeting place is still home to many Indigenous people from across Turtle Island, and we are grateful to have the opportunity to work on this land. Please take a moment to yourself to acknowledge the ancestors of the land in which you are joining us from today. If you are unsure of who the land you are currently situated on belongs to, we invite you to use native-land.ca to find that out. Now, how tonight will run. From all the submissions we received, the judges have shortlisted a group of performers for tonight's live broadcast. After we see some of the performances from our talented performers, our judges will announce winners and prizes, and there will also be an intermission during the event. Viewers and observers, you are encouraged to engage with the performances openly in the chat. We ask that you please don't critique the performances, but you are welcome to encourage and shout out things that you really enjoyed about the performances. And I'll hand it over to Anthony for panel introductions.
Yes, so now we are introducing our lovely panel of judges. And our first one is Avery Jean Brennan. So Avery Jean Brennan is a trans feminine actor, director, musical director, playwright, and producer. And over the past 5 years, they have facilitated workshops on trans inclusive practices in the arts, which they have led for theater and film production companies across Canada. Avery Jean received their musical direction training through various associate and apprenticeship positions in theaters across Canada, including a residency through Neptune Theatre's RBC Chrysalis project. Our next judge of the evening is Stephan Dickson, who is a multi-award-winning choreographer from Toronto, Canada, who has worked in many different areas of the industry, including theater, television, music, and animation. Most recently, he has been a part of the musical creative team and assistant to Donna Fior at the Stratford Festival, working on productions of The Music Man, Little Shop of Horrors, Billy Elliot, and The Rocky Horror Show. As a choreographer, he has also received critical acclaim for his choreography for Mamma Mia and The Rocky Horror Show, and has worked as a choreographer on productions of The Little Mermaid, My Fair Lady, and King Arthur the Panto. And finally, last but definitely, certainly not least, Jennifer Walls is a multidisciplinary artist known for her work as a performer, producer, voice actor, and director. She received critical acclaim both for her portrayal of Liza Minnelli in her solo show, Liza Live, and for her rock cabaret, Jagged Little Me, based on the musical of Alanis Morissette. As a director, she has received critical acclaim for her production of Heathers the Musical and The Rocky Horror Show with Hart House Theatre, for which she received the 2020 Subscribers' Choice Award for Favorite Direction. As a producer, Jennifer is most well known for the popular live musical theater event, Singular Sensation, celebrating 10 years in Toronto. And with that, let's throw it over to Jenny, who's gonna host the next portion of the evening. So, welcome, welcome.
Hi, friends. Thank you, Kimia. Thank you, Anthony. We're all cheering from our homes for you. And you will see these two wonderful humans a little bit later in the evening. So be sure to stick around. Thank you both so much. Hi, everyone. My name is Jenny Walls, and for me, it's a fun thing to be hosting and not hosting and producing. And what just happened there was me being a control freak and not letting everyone else do their job. So we are off to an amazing start. Hello. I'm so, so happy to be here, to be hosting this wonderful event with U of T and Singular Sensation. We have an amazing, amazing group of performers. We got so many submissions, so many wonderful submissions. There is so much talent and energy and creativity out there. And we are just, we feel so privileged and so lucky, the panel and I, to have been able to watch all of your submissions. So thank you so much. Let us know where you're tuning in from tonight. We have some great audience members out there. Let's get interactive and let's support our performers tonight. I know that they definitely appreciate your words and your energy. So let us get started. And I'll fill you in on some details about tonight as we go. We got some prizes. We've got some things going on. But the most important thing about this evening is the performances, and boy, do we have some great ones for you. Our very first performer is Maddie, who is a Hart House theater artist. You may have seen her in Carrie and in Heather's, and she's joining us today from Toronto. Hi, Maddie. So good to see you. Hi,
Jenny. Lovely to see you, too.
How are you?
I'm great. I'm very excited.
Excellent. Well, I'm very excited. We're all very excited. What will you be performing for us today?
So I'm going to be singing I'm Your Man from Meet John Doe.
Excellent. All right. From my living room to all of your living rooms, let's give it up for Maddie.
I'll write just what you say any way that you want. And when it comes to arguing, I'm a savant. I need money. You need me to make a stir, rent my fingers, I'll throw in a Pulitzer. You need someone with talent and passion and brains. You need someone with newspaper ink in their veins. My coffee cup has lipstick stains, but brother, I'm your man. Anything you need done, I'm the one for the job. You want corny, I'll type it right off of the cob. Use my column, any topic, take your pick. I can slalom back and forth on rhetoric. You need someone who crosses her legs and her T's. I'm so quick that I've got my own personal breeze. I've got high heels and two of these, but brother, I'm your man. One day you will regret this, Dick. You could have had me for cheap. You'll say, Anne, please forget this. But I'll say, find a bridge and take a flying leap. You want fireworks? I'll give you the 4th of July. Lots of luck finding somebody better than I. Who could do it? Maybe Dorothy Parker's free. Chief, you blew it. She ain't got a thing on me. Front page headlines. Reed Mitchell will land on her feet. Come tomorrow, some editor's in for a treat. Just say the word, and that's my beat. Brother, I'm your man. Watch out, New York. Here comes a
yes, Maddie. Yes. Thank you so, so much for your performance this evening. It's so good to see you. And hopefully we'll get to do this in person real soon.
Yay. I can't wait.
Amazing. Thanks, Maddie. Oh, yay. I love musical theater. So to let you know, and Anthony and Kimia did such a great job off the top. We'll be watching half of our performers. We have 11, our top 11, and we're going to take a quick break halfway through. A good time to use the bathroom, grab a drink. Stay tuned for maybe a special secret announcement that we have within that time. I'm not going to give it away. I'm just saying. It could happen. And the judges are watching. They are taking their notes, and we will check in with them later on. We're going to bring them up. We're going to have a chat, and they're going to announce the winners of tonight, our top three winners, who will be getting a prize. We love prizes. We love prizes. Our next performer is Frankie Mulder. Frankie is a non-binary performer, writer, and healthcare worker located in Toronto. They are a graduate from the Canadian College of Performing Arts in Victoria, BC. So please welcome Frankie.
Hello.
Oh my goodness. Hey, Frankie, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Amazing. I'm so great. What are you performing?
It's probably hard to tell. I am singing, I Believe, from the Book of Mormon.
Amazing. All right, Frankie, the stage is yours. Take it away.
Thank you. Ever since I was a child, I tried to be the best. So what happened? My family and friends all said I was blessed. So what happened? It was supposed to be all so exciting, to be teaching of Christ across the sea, but I allowed my faith to be shaken. Oh, what's the matter with me? I've always longed to help the needy, to do the things I never dared. This was the time for me to step up. So then why was I so scared? A warlord who shoots people in the face. What's so scary about that? I must trust that my Lord is mightier and always has my back. Now I must be completely devout. I can't have even one shred of doubt. I believe that the Lord God created the universe. I believe that he sent his only son to die for my sins. And I believe that ancient Jews built boats and sailed to America. I am a Mormon, and a Mormon just believes. Oh, now you cannot just believe partway. You have to believe in it all. My problem is doubting the Lord's will instead of standing tall. I can't allow myself to have any doubt. It's time to set my worries free. Time to show the world what all the price is about and share the power inside of me. I believe that God has a plan for all of us. I believe that plan involves me getting my own planet. And I believe that the current president of the church, Thomas Monson, speaks directly to God. I am a Mormon. And dang it, a Mormon just believes. I know that I must go and do the things my God commands. I realize now why he sent me here. If you ask the Lord in faith, he will always answer you. Just believe in him and have no fear. I believe that Satan has a hold of you. I believe that the Lord God has sent me here. And I believe that in 1978, God changed his mind about black people. You can be a Mormon who just believes. Oh, and now I can feel the excitement. This is the moment I was born to do. And it feels so incredible to be sharing my faith with you. The scriptures say that if you ask in faith, if you ask God himself, you'll know. But you must ask him without any doubt and let your spirit grow. I believe that God lives on a planet called Kolob. I believe that Jesus has his own planet as well. And I believe that the Garden of Eden was in Jackson County, Missouri. If you believe, the Lord will reveal it, and you'll know it's all true. You'll just feel it. You'll be a Mormon. And by gosh, a Mormon. Just believes. Oh, I believe. I believe.
Oh, I feel like I'm on Broadway again. Frankie, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Frankie Mulder, everyone. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is filling my heart. It really, really is. And I hope it is for all of you at home. And look at the comments. All of that love and support and applause. Oh, we love it. We love it so much. And I know the performers do as well. Okay, speaking of performers, let's meet our next performer. We have Zia, who is a second year drama student at U of T. Ah, no, we share something in common. Phantom of the Opera was the first musical she watched live in high school, and it has been her inspiration to be a drama major. I feel that. Zia's love for musical theater will live long, and she's very grateful to be part of tonight's event, and we are very grateful to have her. Please welcome Zia to the stage.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. Phantom of the Opera got me too, girl.
Yes, it's the dream.
Listen, I mean, I'll say my hair is inspired. I think that's as close as I'm going to get to the fit.
Yes, I can see that. Uncanny. I love it.
Listen, we do it where we can. We live the dream where we can. What will you be performing for us today?
I will be performing She Used to Be Mine from the musical Waitress.
Wonderful. All right. Take it away, Zia.
Thank you.
It's not simple to say the most days I don't recognize me. These shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons, I've taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken, won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all this mixed up and baked in a beautiful hide. She is gone, but she used to be mine. It's not what I asked. Sometimes life slips in through a back door and carves out the person who makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you, and you're not what I asked for. I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew who was reckless just enough, who gets hurt but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the love that's inside her, getting stronger each day, till it finally reminds her to fight just a little, to bring back the fire in her eyes that's been gone, but you
beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, you take care. We'll see you real soon. Hopefully we'll get to perform in the same room someday.
Bye.
Amazing.
Bye.
Oh goodness. Phantom of the Opera got a lot of us. It got an awful lot of us. It didn't. Wow. These performances, there's so much talent. I can't handle it. The weird voice. I don't know what that was. All right. Speaking of performances, that was my last segue. Someone needs to come up with new material. Who writes the show? It's me. All right. Our next performer has been seen on the Hart House stage and I believe closed a show tonight in Sarnia, but I'm just going to fact check here. So let's bring up our next performer, Mulan.
Hi, Jenny.
Hi, how are you?
Oh, good. I also closed the show today, and so did you.
I did. I don't know if you can hear it. But you just did, like, you were in a show in Toronto and one in Sarnia. What have you been up to? Tell us.
Oh, you know, I'm the commuting queen. So, you know, just doing what I can, performing when I can. It's a beautiful opportunity to be back on stage. So feeling
Absolutely. Very blessed.
It was a
holiday show that you just did this weekend.
Yes, it sure was. I sang a song from Little Women, but, you know, is that a holiday song?
It is if you sing it over the holidays.
In a red
dress. Anything can be a holiday song. Listen, the holidays are what you make of it. Tell us, how was the atmosphere with people being back live and people being back in the theater?
People are so excited and just getting their butts in the seats, and everyone's being really good about like masking up and keeping as safe as possible. So it's been a true blessing. And there's something about having like a live band and music happening in person that just like hits your soul a little bit differently, you know?
Mm, wonderful. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Thank you for sharing that. What will you be performing for us today, Mulan?
I will be singing Backwoods Barbie from 9 to 5.
You take it away. Come on.
Thanks.
Now, I've always been misunderstood because of how I look. So don't judge me by the cover, because I'm a real good book. So read into it what you will, but see me as I am. The way I look is just a country girl's idea of glam. Now I grew up poor and ragged, just a simple country girl. You know, I wanted to be pretty more than anything in the world. Like Bobby's on the models in the Frederick's catalog. From rags to wishes in my dreams, I could have it all. I'm just a backwards Barbie. Too much makeup, too much hair. Don't be fooled by thinking that the goods are not out there. Don't let these false eyelashes lead you to believe that I'm as shallow as I look, cause I run true and deep. I'm just a backwards Barbie in a push-up bra and heels. I might look artificial, but where it counts, I'm real. Yes, I can see how I could be misjudged upon first glance. But even backwards Barbies deserve a second chance. All that I've been hoping for a chance to prove my worth. Cause even backwards Barbies get their feelings hurt.
Mulan, thank you so much.
Thank you, Jenny.
So good to see you. Yee-hoo! All right, we have two more performances, and then we're going to take a short break. And you can go washroom, grab a drink, get a stretch, maybe stay tuned, because we've got some exciting news coming up. But speaking of exciting, we have got more excitement before we do that. So please, we're going to welcome our next performer, Elizabeth. Now, Elizabeth is a York University student. And though she's been singing for most of her life, Elizabeth fell in love with theater over the past few years and is always looking to learn more about this art form that she loves so much. Now, I'm going to bring her up because I want to ask her about the song that she's going to perform, because I think there's a bit of a story to it. Hey, Elizabeth.
Hi, Jenny. How are you?
I'm so good. It's so good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
So there's a bit of a story behind the song that you're doing for us today.
That there is. So today I will be singing Almost There from The Princess and the Frog, Disney's Princess and the Frog. And this song means a lot to me because I remember going to the theater when I was like 7 and watching it and just like falling in love with just the ambiance of the movie and this beautiful song. So I'm really glad that I get to sing it for all of you tonight, all these years later. It's a really cool first full circle moment, which is really cool.
I love that. Thank you for sharing that story with us. That's so beautiful. So I'm not going to delay it any longer. Elizabeth, take it away.
Great. Mama, I don't have time for dancing. That's just gonna have to wait a while. Ain't got time for messing around, and it's just not my style. This whole town can slow you down with people taking the easy way. But I know exactly where I'm going. I'm getting closer and closer every day, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People down here think I'm crazy, but I don't care. Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. But there ain't nothing gonna stop me now, cause I'm almost there. Now I remember Daddy told me the fairy tales can come true. But you've gotta make them happen, it all depends on you. So I work real hard each and every day. Now things for sure are going my way. Just doing what I do. Look out, boys, I'm coming through, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People gonna come here from everywhere, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. Hey. Ooh, yeah. There's been trials and tribulations. Lord knows I've had my share. But I've climbed the mountain and I've crossed the river and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. I'm almost there.
Yes. Yes. Ah, so wonderful.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Oh, no, thank you for sharing that with us, Elizabeth. So wonderful.
Thank you so much, Jenny.
Okay, take care.
Good evening.
Oh, I love a full circle moment. Oh, stunning. Isn't music amazing? And like the adventures and experiences we have with it. So great. I love it. All right. Now, before we take a quick break, I would like to welcome our next performer to the screen. We have Bijou, who is an upcoming artist and fourth year psychology student. Oh, we have to have a chat then. At University of Toronto, Mississauga. And she loves musicals. And I will let her introduce her song. It's from a movie I just happened to watch the other day. So I'm very excited and I know you will be too. So please welcome Bijou to the stage / screen.
Hello, my name is Bijou. Hi, everyone.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. I'm good. I'm doing like I have the time of my life from day to dancing. So yeah, so I love that song.
Yes. Oh, well, it's such a great song. And what a great way to take us into our break. So I hand it over to you. Take it away.
Okay. Thank you. Now I've had the time of my life. Oh, I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's the truth. And I owe it all to you, cause I had the time of my life, and I owe it all to you. I've been waiting for so long, now I finally found someone stand by me.
Yes.
For the writing on the wall, as we felt this magical fantasy. Now with passion in our eyes, there's no way we could disguise it secretly. So we take each other's hands, cause we seem to understand the urgency. Just remember, you're the one thing I can get enough of. So I'll tell you something. This could be love, because I've had the time of my life. Oh, I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's the truth. And I owe it all to you. Ooh, 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 ooh. With my body and soul, I want you more than you ever know. So we'll just let it go. Don't be afraid to lose control. Yes, I know what's on your mind when you say, stay with me tonight. Just remember, you're the one thing I can get enough of. So I'll tell you something. This could be love, because I've had the time of my life. Oh, I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's the truth. And I owe it all to you, cause I had the time of my life. And I've searched through every open door till I found the truth. And I owe it all to you. Ooh. And that's it.
That's it. That was amazing. That was gorgeous.
Thank you
so much. What about this song?
Oh, I did this song in a musical back in high school, and like I got to like sing the song, and just this reminded me of it, and I was like, oh my gosh, this song. And yeah, that's why I chose it again.
That's a great reason. I love how music can just take us back to a time. The time of our lives, even.
I know. Like, it was just, no, I had to do this song again. So yeah.
Oh, well, thank you for choosing to share it with us, because that was stunning. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, take care, Bijou. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is so wonderful. Listen, before we take a break, I just want to thank a few folks who have helped make tonight possible. Of course, Hart House Theater and University of Toronto, and our friends over there, Jillian Lewis, Lindsay Middleton, Doug Floyd, and of course, our amazing work students, Anthony and Kimia. Those two are just incredible. They have worked and done so much to make tonight possible. And of course, our panel, we have Avery Jean Brennan and Stephan Dickson, who you may have seen at the last Hart House workshop that we had with director Jennifer Stewart. Hart House does some really, really fantastic stuff, and education and experiences in a practical way and an inclusive, supportive way are what drives them. And they actually were the first theater I ever worked at as an emerging artist in Toronto as an actor. And then they let me direct for the first time and work as a designer. So they are so about giving people the opportunity to learn on their feet in such a supportive, positive environment. I have definitely learned so much. And when we are able to be there in person again, and you have the opportunity, and they're doing something that, strikes your interest, I really do recommend getting involved with them. Even if you don't want to be on stage, even if crew or design is your passion or you're interested about it, get involved, because like I said, it's a really great opportunity to learn and to thrive and grow and experience things as an artist or as a creative. They've been very good to me, and I'm very grateful for them. And they've been doing such a great job keeping people involved, keeping the community involved over the past couple, almost 2 years where we've been online. So thank you so much to our friends at Hart House University of Toronto. Now, we're going to take a break for a few minutes. We're gonna take a five, smart five. But I wouldn't go too far, because coming up, we have a very exciting announcement on behalf of Singular Sensation. So grab a stretch, grab a drink, but don't go too far, because there's some cool stuff coming up. We'll see you in a bit. here, co-producer and host of Singular Sensation. Now, some of you may know we have existed as an online show for the past almost 2 years. Can you believe it? But I am so excited to announce, well, why am I doing this by myself? I'm going to bring in a friend to help me. Hey there, Mandy Goodhandy.
Hello. You were just about to make an important announcement. What was it?
But I don't feel like I should do it alone. Mandy, what is our exciting announcement to tell the people?
Well, people, for all of those out there that already know, we lost 120 Diner because of COVID, and then because of the landlord that's been crushed into the ground, but not in spirit, or not the two spirits that were living in the building either. And now we're reopening, not as 120 Diner, but as Mandy's Bistro, and it's at 123 Danforth. That's Danforth and Broadview. And I had Singular Sensation in mind as one of the events that you never know, but that's up to Jenny. It's her event. But we would love to have all you wonderful people there. If you can make it, can they make it?
I think they can make it. We're going to make it.
We're going to be there. Yes.
We'll be there because Singular Sensation, as of January 2022, will be returning live at Mandy's Bistro on the Danforth, starting the third Monday of the month in January.
Isn't that incredible? That's incredible. I'm so excited. I can't wait. I have to pick out an outfit and a song and pop out of a cake of some kind. I don't know yet what the presentation will be, but I can't wait to have all you young people back and older people back. And I can't wait to hear your beautiful voices again and feel your beautiful energy at Mandy's Bistro. And of course, it doesn't have to be Singular Sensation. Come by anytime. Check our website, www. For those that don't know about the W's, okay, it's mandysbistro.com, and check the events and please come by whenever you want.
Well, you have always been such a supporter and advocate for the arts, and we're so grateful for you and excited for your new venue. Congratulations on Standing Bistro. You are truly the phoenix to rise and open a new venue all in one pandemic. And we're just so excited to set up shop as our home base at Mandy's Bistro the third Monday of the month, just like it was at the diner.
Yeah.
And I can't wait to see you all. It's going to be so fun.
It is, isn't it? It's like I've got some singed, you know, feathers I have to wipe off before all that happens and all that can happen. And for all those people out there that are in music theater now and are starting to work again, and have been working on projects, whether it's online or offline, I'm so proud of you all. I see the people who are friends of mine on Facebook, I see your posts and what you're accomplishing out there. And I'm just so, so thrilled for all of you, including you, Jenny, and your online show. Very successful.
Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you. Well, we can't wait to return to the stage and to be in the same room and to just celebrate in song. Mandy, thank you for welcoming us. We can't wait.
Thank you for having me on.
See you soon, everyone.
Love you all.
Oh my goodness. So yeah, we love Mandy Goodhandy, and we can't wait to go back to being live on stage at Mandy's Bistro on the Danforth. Yes, I almost called it the 120 Diner. It's been a long day. But it's Mandy's Bistro, 123 Danforth Avenue. It's right near Broadview Station. It's where the old Nick used to be, if you're familiar with that venue. And we're going to make sure everyone is safe and comfortable. And it's always going to continue to be our safe and inclusive space for community and supporting one another. And I can't wait to see you in the same room on stage live. My head's exploding. So I thought it would be fun, before we bring up our next batch of performers, maybe we'll check in with our panel. We love a little check-in. So please join me in welcoming to the screen my fellow adjudicators for the evening, Avery Jean Brennan and Stephan Dickson.
Hi.
Hi. How are you, friends?
I'm doing great. I'm here reporting live from, you know, the one room with no windows that every 30-year-old music director has with a piano in it. So here we are.
You know, living my best life, just enjoying some amazing voices and loving being able to, you know, just enjoy a Sunday of lovely music and lovely people.
Yeah. Right? Isn't it, though? So give us a bit of an insight. What kind of things do you look for when adjudicating a performance like this, like a musical theater slam? What are you looking for? Avery Jean, I'll start with you.
Yeah, well, from a music standpoint, what I'm always looking for in auditions and performances and this, I'm always looking for shape within the vocals. And what I mean by that is just kind of like use of dynamics and texture and playing with different parts of your voice. What I don't love is just hearing like, here's my 32 bars of just belting as loud as I can. That doesn't tell me a lot. It tells me you can do that, which is very impressive. But for me, the storytelling really lies in how you allow the dynamics to assist you in telling that story. And we've seen some incredible examples of that tonight already. So I'm having a great time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I feel like maybe we get caught up in how high and how big can we get, forgetting how beautiful and intimate and intricate the opposite is. So I really appreciate you saying that. Yeah. Bigger and higher is not necessarily better. Stephan, now I know that you were a part of the workshop as a choreographer, but you also work as a director and choreographer. So what are you looking for in general?
Well, you know, I have to agree with Avery Jean, and I love, you know, the use of dynamics and everything. And what I find, what I really love to look for is storytelling. I'm really into, you know, knowing your piece and understanding and building a story behind it, having a purpose for saying these lyrics and taking us on a journey with you. So I really love to see, you know, what story you're telling, the discoveries that you're having within. Are they old discoveries, new discoveries? Just seeing that to be able to like see the world through this character's eyes. So I'm looking for that kind of stuff.
Nice. Thank you for sharing that, both of you. And I, as I, a panelist too, surprise, I would agree with that. I mean, we sing when we can no longer speak, and a song is a story with music. So it really is at the end of the day about the story that you're telling and what dynamics or what shape, what texture, what color supports the story you're telling. And when I'm teaching, I tell my students, a lot of people can sing, but what story are you telling? Because we're storytellers. So I really appreciate you offering that insight. I mean, it's usually this is where I'd say, I don't envy your job. Everyone's so talented, but I'm with you. So I don't envy myself either. This is a really fantastic group of performers that we have tonight.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And before we get back to them, I also want to say, like, I know we aren't giving out awards until the end, but I do have to give one out already. To you, Jenny, for best brows.
Yes. Brows today.
Like everyone at home, like make some noise for Jenny Walls's brows over here. Thank we can't actually hear it. So make really loud. Jenny looks amazing, and I've been spending this whole night just watching, being like, oh my God, this is great. And
you're on point, on point.
So good. And Jenny has done so much, not just tonight, but through this entire pandemic, to create spaces for musical theater and conversation about this art form. This entire two, however many years we've been doing this. And I want us all to publicly acknowledge and thank Jenny for everything that she does here for us. So.
Heck yeah. Woo!
And back to both of you, just thank you. Thank you for that. And thank you for doing this. And thank you for all of the submissions. I should let everyone know at home. We had over 24 submissions, and each of those submissions, the panel watched and gave feedback. So these wonderful people above me here, they took time as well to give their feedback in a constructive way. And we had a comment from, in our comments here, you have to make me understand and feel why you couldn't say this through speaking. And Tanisha, you're absolutely right. It is true. Why? What are the stakes? And it's so true. And thank you for including that in our comments, because it is so, so important. So we're gonna get into some more storytelling.
over 2 dozen, sorry, not 2,000. That would be a lot of, we'd still be giving feedback, but wouldn't that be great if we had that many people want to share their work with us? Something to build up to. But thank you both so much for checking in with us and for being here tonight. And we'll see in a few more performances where we give out our awards. Well, the rest of the awards. I mean, thank you.
Yeah, so sorry to everyone else who is also trying to compete for Best Brows.
Can't. Okay, let's get back to the serious business of the night. Avery Jean Brennan and Stephan Dickson, we'll see you both in a little bit. Oh my goodness. Okay. Just a little stand-up comedy for the evening. Okay, but we are getting back to what we are here for. Our next performer is Mahadissa, and Mahadissa is a theater maker and performer who cannot wait to be doing this in person for you someday soon. And we cannot wait for them to do it in person as well. So please join me in welcoming Mahadissa to the stage. Welcome, welcome.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I can't wait to be able to do this in person either.
Yeah, it's going to be a blast.
It is. It is. Well, maybe we'll have to get you out to Mandy's Bistro to come to an in-person singular and enjoy it all in person.
I got so excited to see that because it's very, I live in Leslieville, so it's so close.
Some things are meant to be.
Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, this is about you and your performance, so I'm going to hand it right over to you. So please take it away.
Thanks. I was 5 and he was 6. We played on the horses made of sticks. He wore black and I wore white. He would always win the fight. Bang, bang, he shot me down. Bang, bang, I hit the ground, bang, bang. That awful sound, bang, bang. My baby shot me down. Seasons came and changed the time, but when I grew up, I called him mine. He would always laugh and say, remember when we used to play? Bang, bang, I shot you down. Bang, bang, you hit the ground. Bang, bang, that awful sound, I used to shoot you down. Music played and people sang. Just for me, the church bells rang. Thank you.
Woo! Yes! Oh my goodness. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Our absolute pleasure. Thank you. I love that song. All right, our next performer is Kara. And Kara is a fourth year student of history and philosophy at U of T. She's an active member of the U of T campus theater community and has worked on a number of productions as a performer, sketch writer, and costume designer. Now, the piece she picked today is quite significant to her. So I'm going to actually bring in Kara to tell us about the song.
Hello.
Hi, Kara. Now you have a very special story about the show and the song that you are performing for us today. Would you want to share that with us?
Yes. So I will be performing the song No One Else from Natasha and Pierre and the Great Comet of 1812, which, by the way, was robbed. It holds special significance to me because most, if not all, I think the actresses who have played the role of Natasha have been an actress of color. And I don't know, that's just really special to me because I feel like Natasha is the type of character that we don't get to see a lot of women of color portray. Like, she's an ingenue. Like, as much as I do appreciate stories about, our experiences with racism, but I don't just want to do stories like that. I believe that we fully have the range to be ingenues and villains and funny women as well.
Absolutely. And thank you for sharing that. I couldn't agree more. And I'm so glad that you're joining us today. You look stunning. Your voice is stunning. And listen, this is all about you now, Kara. Please take it away.
Moonlight burst into the room, and I saw your eyes, and I saw your smile, and the world opened wide, and the world was inside of me, and I catch my breath, and I laugh and blush, and I hear guitars. You are so good for me. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Oh, the moon. Oh, childlike eyes and your distant smile, I'll never be this happy again, you and I, and no one else. We've done this all before. We were angels once, don't you remember? Joy and life inside our souls, and nobody knows, just you and me. It's our secret. This winter sky, how can anyone sleep? There was never such a night before. I feel like putting my arms on my knees and squeezing tight as possible and flying away. Like this.
Thank you so much. So
thank you for having me.
Oh, our absolute pleasure. Thank you. Take care.
Bye.
Oh my goodness. I am nerding out on these performances. All right. Our next performer is Shelley. And Shelley is a music and drama student at U of T. Now, she describes herself as a true triple threat because her passion for singing, acting, and dancing. Now, aside from performing, Shelley also loves writing and directing plays. So please join me in welcoming to the screen, Shelley. Hi.
Hi, Jenny.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm so good. I'm so glad that you're here.
Yeah, I'm now, glad. I'm excited.
I'm so glad. So are we. Now, what are you going to be singing for us today?
I will be singing She Used to Be Mine. I believe it is the second time you guys have heard it.
Listen, this is what I think. Sing whatever song you want. If it's your song, if it feels right, if it's connected, if you can, you know, if it means something to you, do it. It can be done 1,000 times. And anyone in the comments can weigh in on that. That's totally fine. But we have a... I'm also Nina. Okay, so listen. Can never be too many times for this one. So grab your Kleenex, because we're going back into some Waitress. Take it away, Shelley.
Thank you.
So I've got my essay written, and I've been working on it for about a week. So now I'm going to show you how I use Grammarly to edit.
To say that most days I don't recognize me, but these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true, I was never attention sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She's all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She's gone, but she used to be mine. slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you. And you're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew who'd be reckless just enough, who gets hurt but who burns out and toughens up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, growing stronger each day till it finally reminds her to fight just a little, to bring back the fire in her eyes that's been gone, but it used to be mine. It used to be mine. She's all of this mixed and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be.
Yes, Shelley, and just to read from the comments, everyone has a different, something different that connects them to material and shows us that something is different, something in different ways. So glad to hear two versions of this tonight. So, well done.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us tonight. It was such a pleasure. Thank you.
Pleasure was all mine.
Thank you. Soon. Talk soon.
Talk soon.
It's true. Nobody sees a painting the same way. Nobody listens to music the same way. Nobody performs a song the same way. So never let that limit you. Just my like 2 cents. That you didn't ask for, but I'm getting anyway. All right, our next performer is Evelyn. Evelyn is a student currently studying Sheridan's Musical Theater Performance Program. Performing music has always been her passion, and she's so excited to carry it into her future. Now, we're going to bring her up, and I will let her introduce her song tonight. So please, welcome Evelyn.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, I'm so great. How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
Wonderful. So what have you chosen to perform for us this evening?
Today, I'll be singing the song The View from Here from the musical Darling by Ryan Scott Oliver.
Yes, big fan. Okay, listen, the stage is yours. Take it away.
Thank you.
Austin at sunset, fog machine from
Thank you.
onto the streets, onto my feet, into
Evelyn, thank you so much.
Thanks.
What a treat. Oh my gosh. Wow. What a night. Oh, what a night. Well, we're in musical theater land. I'll drop a little something, something for you. So we are down to our last performer, if you can believe it. I don't know where this evening went. I thank you so much again to everyone who submitted, even if you're not part of the top 11. It takes a lot of guts and a lot of courage and a lot of work to get up the courage to submit to something and put yourself on camera and put yourself out there for strangers you don't know to watch you and offer you feedback. So congratulations and thank you to everyone that submitted for taking that chance, making that leap. That is a huge accomplishment in itself. And to our top 11, thank you all for being here tonight and performing live. It is, even though we've been doing it for the better part of 2 years, I feel like it never feels any more natural. It you know, it's not a like, oh, I feel very comfortable doing this online. When you're used to being with people, it's such an energy exchange. So thank you and congratulations to all of our performers here tonight, because it's a huge accomplishment as well. And while, you know, there's a top three at the end of the night, you are all incredible. Like, and I speak for the whole panel, we are absolutely blown away by everyone's talent here tonight. And we're not even finished yet. Last but certainly not least, we have Colette, who is a multidisciplinary theater artist with a musical theater focus, originally from Vancouver, BC. And after completing her training at the American Musical and Dramatic Academy in New York City, she relocated to Toronto to pursue arts management at U of T. Oh, we should talk. And where she has been working as a producer, both within and outside of the university community for the past 3 years. Now, you can follow her journey on the Instagram, and we'll put that up on screen. Ooh, we're on TikTok as well. I don't know how to use the TikTok, but maybe we can ask Colette and she can give, we can have a whole conversation about it later. It is the future, so I'm told. by people much younger and hipper than me. But it's not about me. It's about Colette. Welcome, Colette, onto the stage.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. I'm very good. I'm very good. Now, I'm not going to grill you on TikTok. everybody go follow her. Colette A.V. Richardson.
Yes.
On TikTok.
On the TikTok.
That's how you can tell I don't do it, because I say the. It's like when your parents say the Facebook.
It's a learning curve. It takes a minute. It took me a minute too, trust me.
Well, if it takes you a minute, it's going to take me a year. And that's just how it's going to be. And that's why Singular Sensation works with University of Toronto with an intern team. But we'll talk about that later. Anyhow, this is not about TikTok. It's about you, girl. What are you going to sing for us tonight to wrap up our performances?
I'm going to be singing Meadowlark from The Baker's Wife.
Yes, you are. All right. Colette, you're going to be fabulous, darling. Take it away.
When I was a girl, I had a favorite story of the meadowlark who lived where the rivers wind. Her voice could match the angels in its glory, but she was blind. The lark was blind. An old king came and took her to his palace, where the walls were burnished bronze and golden braid. And he fed her fruit and nuts from an ivory chalice, and he prayed, "Sing for me, my meadow lark, sing for me your silver warning. Set me free, my meadow lark, and I'll buy you a priceless jewel and a cloth of brocade and crewel, and I'll love you for life if you will sing for me." And then one day the lark sang by the water. The god of the sun heard her in his flight, and her singing moved him, so he came and brought her the gift of sight. He gave her sight, and she opened her eyes to the shimmer and the splendor of this beautiful young god, so proud and strong. And he called the lark in a voice both rough and tender, "Come along, fly with me, my meadow lark, fly with me on a silver morning, past the sea where the dolphins bark. We will dance on the coral beaches, make a feast of the plums and peaches, just as far as your vision reaches. Fly with me." The meadow lark said no, for the old king loved her so. She couldn't bear to wound his pride. And when the sun god flew away, and the king came down that day, he found his meadow lark had died. Every time I heard that part, I cried. And now I stand here, starry-eyed and stormy. Oh, just when I thought my heart was finally numb, a beautiful young man appeared before me, saying, "Come, oh, won't you come? And what can I do if finally, for the first time, when I'm yearning for returns the glow? If love has come at last, it's picked the worst time. Still I know I've got to go. Fly away, meadow lark, fly away on a silver morning. If I stay, I'll grow to curse the dark. So it's off for the days won't bind me. I know I leave wounds behind me, but I won't let tomorrow find me back the
before my past once again can blind me. Fly away. And we won't wait to say goodbye. My beautiful young man. And I.
Yes. Yes. And you had a long rehearsal day today, didn't you?
Yes. I had a show. I've been at rehearsal since about noon, so I've been singing all day.
You sure have. Well, you sounded fantastic.
Thank you very much.
No, thank you, Colette. Thank you so much, and all the best with your rehearsal.
Thank you. Bye.
Take care. Bye. Oh, my goodness. These comments. I am a living for them. Okay, so listen, we are going to, well, that is all of our, that's our top 11. That is all of them. And we're just going to take a short little break, a little teeny tiny little break, and the judges are going to deliberate. I feel like I'm on a reality TV show. The judges are going to deliberate, and we will be back with the top three performances of the night. So don't go anywhere. We will be right back with the winners. I want to thank Kimia at U of T for making all of those great U of T spotlight videos for us tonight. Amazing, amazing. And again, such a huge thanks to Kimia and Anthony and Jillian Lewis and Lindsay Middleton and Doug Floyd with Hart House for all of their help and hard work making tonight's event possible. I don't know about y'all, but wow, this has been such a fun night. So inspiring, so uplifting. Best way to end a week. And I'm just so thrilled. Thank you all for joining us. Thank you for being there in the comments. Thank you for all your support of our performers tonight. This has been absolutely fantastic. This is the first time we've ever done this event, this inaugural musical theater slam. And I think we may have to do another one because this was pretty rad. So thanks again to everyone who submitted, to everyone who joined us tonight, and for all of you for taking the time and bringing the energy to throw towards our performers tonight. We really appreciate it. Time is precious, and we know that things are happening out in the world. We're not stuck at home, so it's not as simple as just tuning in, but you chose to tonight to support these performers. So thank you very much. Now, the time has come. The Walls wrist said, get it? Walls. My last name's Walls. Yeah. I'm the only one who finds that funny even still. But this is not about me and my sense of humor. This is about our performers tonight. So please join me in welcoming back my fellow panelists, Avery Jean Brennan and Stephan Dickson.
Hey, great joke, Jeff. Great joke.
Hi, friends. So,
kudos on the joke.
How about that for an evening?
So good. It was such a great, great evening. All 11 performances really, really, really were just really wonderful, and it was very hard, as you know, through our private group chat of what, oh my God. And I really wanted to make sure we drive home too before we even give out any of the prizes that like everyone who showed up tonight, like did such a great job. And I think I speak for all three of us when I say I am so, 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 so grateful for everybody who came out here and gave their time to us and gave their talent to us. Like, mm-hmm. And every audition panel I ever sit in, all I ever feel is gratitude for the people who come in for me. And I feel that exactly tonight as well. So thank you.
Truly, truly. And I mentioned earlier that out of all of the participants, they all got feedback. Some participated in a workshop as well. And I have to say that of the performances we saw tonight, so much of the feedback we gave only a week ago, mm-hmm. how much numbers have grown within that week, which is so cool.
Yeah.
So cool. Any last thoughts before we dig into our top three, Stephan Dickson?
No, I said, let's get to it. I just want to say congratulations really quickly to everybody. It was such a wonderful evening, beautiful, beautiful talent. And for everyone who submitted, it was such a treat to be able to hear all your amazing voices and see all your amazing talent. So thank you so much.
Agreed. Seconded. Thirded, fifted. That's a word now. Okay, so, Avery Jean, shall we start with your top pick of the night? And all of our top performers will be receiving a gift card that we'll be getting to you via email. So if for any reason you're not tuning in at this moment, for whatever reason, you will get your gift card in the email. What is it with me and the tonight? Apparently it's my favorite word. So our winners will be getting a gift card as an award for their performance tonight. Avery Jean Brennan, do tell.
That's me.
You.
I am so excited tonight to present an award that I invented during this show called the Dynamic Dynamics Award. Presented by Avery Jean, which is me. The winner of this award is the person who gave me exactly what I've asked for even before tonight, which I've said, like, dynamics. And the real trick with dynamics is that they also have to come from your storytelling. You know, you don't want to just like, I'm singing quietly just because, like, no, why are you singing quietly? Why are you singing loudly? And this is an individual who had an excellent, excellent understanding of this. This person could fly in between their belt, their head voice, their mix, their chest voice, everything. These beautiful crescendos and incredible decrescendos all throughout their performance. I basically cried during both the original video submission that I watched and their performance tonight. And that winner is Evelyn Hecht. For the view from here, from Darling.
Congratulations, Evelyn. Look at these post-it notes. They're amazing.
I'll be mailing Evelyn this dry erase marker.
Excellent. The post-it will be in the mail.
Exactly.
I feel a huge lack of office supplies in this. I have puppets made by our friend Adam Prue right back here.
But I can't send that in the mail, sadly. Also because it's not mine. So I get in a lot of trouble.
I also need a dry eraser for my chalkboard, so.
So with post-it notes. Let me see. What do I have in here? I have a bit too. It's called What's in My Friend's Desk Drawer. Not as good. Amazing. So congratulations, Evelyn. And it was a tough choice to make. There's so many amazing performances. Stephan, who's your top pick?
So yeah, it was amazing performances all around. It was a really, really tough decision, as you know, as we all know through our conversation. But really, I do have to echo what you said about seeing the video submissions that we received about a week ago, and the growth that has come through. And so that's amazing, and it shows, you know, great artistry, great dedication. And so congratulations to all on that. My award, I have a fun little name that I tried to, I don't know if it's going to compete with yours, Avery Jean, but I'm like doing my best, as I come, you know, reporting to you from the set of Castaway, the musical. I would like to say, my award is called, Coming In With a Bang. And I'd like to give this to Mahadissa, for her, rendition of Bang Bang, a amazing song. And I also just have to say, like, you had a great attack right off the top, and your storytelling was amazing. Like, you came in right with, and like, you had this like raw, playful banter that I really connected to right off the top, as you like just introduced us into the story. And then you just continued to take us on this amazing roller coaster. Even in the musical break there, you could see, you know, the journey and the realization. And what I love as a director, when I see like songs or scenes or anything, I love being able to, when I start to see the scene in my head, I know I'm in the right space, and you really took me there. So congratulations, and keep it up.
Yes, thanks, Stephan. Cast Away the Musical. I mean, yeah.
Why not?
Well done. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's hard to pick, but my my top award is going to Zia for She Used to Be Mine. While I agree that, yeah, I agree that this song is done a lot, but I understand why it's done a lot. And I really appreciated the storytelling and the emotional journey and the emotional intensity without vocal volume, which I really appreciated, because it's easy to sometimes get, you know, to get intensify everything. And I felt like it was a really expressive performance, and I really, really appreciated it vocally and emotionally and storytelling. It was very clear to me, and I really went on a journey with that song. So Zia, congratulations. You will all be getting a gift card through email from U of T. And I know we say they're all winners, but tonight, performers, our top 11, you really are all winners, because we will also be sending everyone a gift card. So our top three will be getting an additional one, but everyone who performed tonight, we will be sending you a gift, because you are all gifts to us. And we so appreciate your time and your talents and your vulnerability and your bravery, and just, we're very grateful, and thank you for making this event tonight so special. So they will be coming to all of you. And it was really tough. Everyone had something so special and so unique to their performances. And I'm just so, so grateful for all of your time and talent. Avery Jean and Stephan, thank you very much for joining us tonight, for being on the panel, for watching all the submissions, for sending all of the wonderful feedback, and super, super grateful.
I have to remind everyone as well, the real winner of tonight.
Best Bros!
And I think we have one more thing as well to present.
Yes! Oh my God, thank you. We also have, y'all, what would I do without you, Avery Jean?
It was actually Anthony wrote it in our
private. We also have a wild card here. I was like,
I'm the wild card. They're like, is she going to say it? Is she not? Is she going to do her job? What's happening here? We also have a wild card winner who is not one of the top 11. And it's a top 11 because there was a tie. Not just because I don't like even numbers. I like even numbers. That has nothing to do with it. But our wild card winner we have is Amanda. Amanda Shiloh Braverman. So you will also be getting a prize for being our wild card performer. From your wild card host who always keeps you on your toes for if she's going to read her script or not. It was a bit. It wasn't a bit. Nobody.
We all planned it. We planned this just like
it was planned.
Nobody.
It was great. Amazing.
Well, I got one of those stamps from TikTok. This isn't it. This is freehand. But I'll tell you, if you don't put that stamp on correctly, you look like you're confused all the time. Anyway. This is not about my brows. Well, thank you, Avery Jean, for making it.
I mean, it's not about your brows.
Yeah.
That's true. I guarantee that's at least 5% of the reason why I'm here right now.
There you go.
Listen, whatever gets you here to share your glorious self and wisdom and energy with us, I will do it. Thank you all again. Thank you, Stephan. Thank you, Avery Jean. We're going to say goodbye for tonight, but thank you for everything. And, I think maybe we'll have to do this again.
I'm free.
Yeah, I would love to.
Alrighty, alrighty, alrighty. Take care, you two.
Thank you.
So congratulations to our top three, to our wild card winner, and to all of our performers, all of our submissions, and for all of the amazing comments tonight. We had some really great insights from some really fantastic creatives in our community. We had some great support from the community as well, and I'm just so, so grateful. And tonight would not be what it was without our two hosts, my fellow hosts, Anthony and Kimia. Let's bring them back up on screen to say hello. Hey, you two.
Hi, what a great event. Oh my gosh, that was awesome.
Wasn't that fantastic? There's so much talent.
So much talent.
My goodness. Well, listen, I can't thank you both enough for everything that you've done to make tonight the success that it is. And maybe we'll have to do this again, I'm thinking.
I think we need to.
Oh, I think so.
I think we need to.
Thank you, Jenny, for being your amazing self and for hosting.
And thank you, Stephan and Avery Jean, so much, and all of the lovely performers. Thank you all so, so much. You all killed it.
Yeah. And we can't wait to see you all in person at Mandy's Bistro in January when Singular Sensation is live and we can do this in person and sing to each other in the same room, and it's going to be wonderful. So if I wasn't excited about that before, I certainly am now. So from all of us here at Singular Sensation and U of T Hart House Theater, thank you all for tuning in. Thank you all for sharing your love and light. And we will see you again real soon. Take care, everyone.